Good morning, everyone. So today's topic is on the role of tocilizumab in COVID-19 management. So interleukin-6 is a pro-inflammatory cytokine produced by a variety of cell types, which include lymphocytes, monocytes, and fibroblasts. And infection by the coronavirus induces the dose-dependent production of interleukin-6. And it's a mediator of severe systemic inflammatory response, which is called as cytokine storm. And this is considered to be one of the major cause of ARDS and development of multi-organ failure. This is the interleukin-6, basically the cell sources of cells. It's produced by T cells, endothelial cells, fibroblasts, macrophages, and monocytes. And these are the cellular targets. And the main effect will be like acting on B lymphocytes, which help in proliferation and differentiation and production of antibiotics. On T cells, induce cytotoxic T lymphocyte activity. It's an acute phase reactive protein as well. And these are the disease which where the pathogenesis of interleukin-6 has been linked. So you can see it's been linked to disease like COPD, cytokine release syndrome, etc. So coming to cytokine release syndrome, basically characterized by a sharp increase in level of a large number of pro-inflammatory cytokines. Common in immune system related diseases or immune related therapy like CAR therapy, organ transplant sepsis, and certain viral infections. The SARS coronavirus 2 binds to the alveolar epithelial cells, then it activates the innate and adaptive immune system, resulting in release of a large number of cytokines, including interleukin-6. So it impedes the alveolar gas exchange and contributes to a high mortality in severe COVID-19 patients. The heightened cytokine release indicated by elevated blood levels of interleukin-6, C-reactive protein, D-dimer, and ferritin, but not typically by procalcitonin. So the timely control of this cytokine storm in the early stage is key to improve the treatment success and reducing the mortality rate in patients with COVID-19. So what is tocilizumab? It is a basically humanized anti-interleukin-6 receptor antibody of the IgG1 subclass. It specifically binds to the soluble and membrane-bound interleukin-6 receptors and inhibits the signal transduction, which will be described in subsequent picture. So the current indications are, it's indicated in rheumatoid arthritis, juvenile idiopathic arthritis, giant cell arthritis, and cytokine release syndromes. So basically, this is an interleukin-6 molecule. It has two receptors, there's transmembrane receptors as well as soluble receptors. So it can bind with the, can either act the, through the transmembrane receptor or bind to the soluble receptor. And through this, they act by the glycoprotein 130. They activate the signal transduction, which results in the inflammatory storm. So tocilizumab binds with both this transmembrane receptor and soluble receptor as well. So prevents the interleukin-6 by exerting its signal transduction and therefore decreases the inflammatory storm. So the dosing in cytokine release syndrome in COVID-19, it's from up to date. It's an off-label use has been mentioned. It's usually given the intravenous route. 8 milligram per kilo, per kg body weight is the standard dose, usually given as a single dose. And the dose can be repeated 8 to 12 hours later based on the symptoms. Usually it's symptoms of fever and other clinically it's not improving. Usually it's not given more than 3 doses in trials. So the adverse effects are usually elevated liver enzymes, which is appears to be a dose dependent. Neutropenia, thrombocytopenia, serious infections, been described in the context of continuous dosing. So in the setting of a COVID-19 with a off-label use of 1 or 2 doses, usually these side effects are not described. Hypersensitivity and injection site reaction. So we'll see certain trials, studies. So we don't have any randomized control RCTs, a large observation study on the role of tocilizumab in severe COVID. So this first is a non-randomized open-label trial in severe COVID-19 patients. It was described from China and with a sample size of 21. So basically they observed the clinical changes in the clinical symptoms, CT scan and lab reports. So the case definition, they defined severe cases as like with a respiratory rate of more than 30, saturation of less than 93 in room air, and PaO2 by FiO2 ratio of less than 300. So critical cases were defined as patients who with respiratory failure who required mechanical ventilation, patient with shock, and combined with other organ failure which needed an ICU admission. So all these patients received standard care, which included lopinavir, methylprednisolone, and other symptom relievers and oxygen therapy. And tocilizumab was given at a dose of 400 milligram once through an IV drip. So among the 21 patients, 18 patients received tocilizumab one dose, single dose, and 3 patients received 2 doses. And second dose was administered after 12 hours due to recurrence of fever. CT was done on admission and 1 week after the treatment. So these are the baseline characteristics. The median age group was 56.8 years, predominantly of male population. So these are the associated comorbidities. So almost all patients had fever, and cough was the next predominant symptom. And the severity of illness, like 17 patients had a severe illness and 4 patients had a critical illness. So 2 patients were on invasive ventilation. Other patients were receiving, like majority were receiving high flow oxygen. 7 were in nasal cannula. 1 patient was getting non-invasive ventilation. Other patient was receiving mask oxygen. So these were the laboratory parameters. They considered lymphocyte percentage, C-reactive protein, and procalcitonin levels at the onset and at the end of 5 days after therapy. So if you see the lymphocyte percentage, usually lymphopenia was observed in this COVID-19 patients, and gradually with the therapy, the lymphocyte percentage increased. There is a dramatic fall in the level of C-reactive protein at the end of therapy, from beginning to the end of therapy. Procalcitonin, not much, which is not a parameter also to be elevated in cases of cytokine storm. So the results, coming to the clinical parameters, the fever was normalized within 24 hours after therapy, and all the symptoms improved. Based on oxygen requirement, 15 patients had lowered their oxygen intake, but how much was not mentioned. One patient needed no oxygen therapy. So 2 patients who were on mechanical ventilator were off the ventilator within 5 days after the treatment. And in CT scan, lung opacity was improved in 90% of the patients. Laboratory parameters, like lymphocyte percentage, returned to normal in 50% of the patients at on 5th day. And elevated C-reactive protein decreased in 84% of the patients by the end of therapy. None of the patients died. And 19 patients survived to discharge, and 2 patients were in hospital at the end of the follow-up. So no adverse drug reactions were reported. So this study had certain limitations. It was non-randomized, a small sample size, retrospective design, and a single center study. Also, the baseline oxygen, like how much significant it was reduced, also not mentioned in the trial. So this trial supports the use of tocilizumab in patients, and based on clinical improvement as well as improving radiologically, and the improvement in the parameters of C-reactive protein and lymphocytes. So this is another retrospective based case series from Wuhan, China. A sample size of 15. They considered the baseline demographic, treatment, laboratory parameters, and parameters were CR reactive protein and interleukin-6 before and after the therapy, and clinical outcomes were retrospectively assessed. So the median age group was slightly older population. It was 73 years. Severity, like 2 patients were moderately ill, 6 were seriously ill, and 7 were critically ill. But the criteria, like previously described study, like which patient will be moderately ill and seriously and critically ill, was not described in this study. 10 patients had 1 hour had comorbidities. 8 patients received methylprednisolone also. 5 patients received tocilizumab twice or more. The dose was 80 to 600 milligram per time. And the number of deaths were 3. And all these 3 patients were critically ill at the onset of treatment. So 2 patients worsened. So among which 1 patient was in the critically ill arm, other patient was in the seriously ill group. So the treatment with tocilizumab decreased CRP levels in all patients, except for 4 patients who were critically ill who received a single dose of tocilizumab. So among these patients, 3 of them died, and the rest 1 patient had a worsening of clinical parameters. Coming to interleukin-6 levels, in 10 patients, like the interleukin-6 level decreased, and in other 5, there was no reduction in the interleukin-6 levels, and among these, 4 patients who were critically ill had a persistent and dramatic increase in interleukin 6. All these were the similar patients who were there was observed who had a raised CRP levels. So the critically ill subset did not have a did not have an improvement in CRP levels as well as in interleukin 6 levels. So the limitations it is non-randomized. The criteria of severity was not described, and like why only a few patients received methylprednisolone was also not clear, and the results were predominantly based on lab parameters. The clinical parameters and radiological parameters were not taken into account. So these are the only two studies I could find about tocilizumab. So few randomized control trials have been approved, and many trials like they combine the role of immunoglobulins, other antiviral agents also. One trial had particularly looked upon the role of HCQ, azithromycin, and tocilizumab in patients. So these are all randomized control trials on the way. So to conclude, interleukin 6 plays an important role in the cytokine storm in severe COVID-19 patients, and the role in cytokine releasing syndromes due to CAR therapy is well defined. However, there are only anecdotal reports of improved oxygenation, systemic inflammation, and hypoxic respiratory failure with tocilizumab. However, no data from randomized control trials or large observational cohort describing the efficacy of this drug. So, hence the present evidence does not support the use in severe COVID patients suspected to have a cytokine storm outside the clinical trials.
Arun, good presentation. Has this been used in any other viral illness before?
Sir, a few have been mentioned in the MERS infections. Like few data have been described in MERS. Apart from that, like these were the only reports in COVID-19. So few reports of being used in MERS infection, I could see some trials. Sir.